So, what's your plan, Mr. Garrett?
How would you like to buy a bank?
What the hell do we know about banking?
Owning a bank is like owning the other side of the real estate business.
There's a few complexities you just left out.
Like what?
Oh, I'm sorry. Did I not wake up black this morning? Because I'm pretty sure I did. Yep, still black.
I got my head full of dreams.
I came here to try my hand at real estate.
You mad at millionaire units?
The time never
I like seeing black men succeed. Sometimes I even invest some of my own money to back them. I know you're smart and ambitious.
You and I both know that's not enough.
It's time that someone shine a bright light in order for things to change.
Are you starting to buy real estate in white-only neighborhoods?
Keep one eye open.
Think about all the good we can do for the community.
Taking it to the man.
That's exactly what we're gonna do.
And just how in the hell do you plan on pulling that off?
We get Matt to front for us.
You want me to what?
Be us to the rest of the world.
We can't set foot in the bank unless we the help.
Should have took limo driver when you had the chance.
I don't know anything about banking. I don't know how to buy a bank.
We'll teach you everything you need to know.
You gotta learn how to talk to rich white folks like you one of them.
And you can't fake a golf game.
Make me proud, son.
Whole country's talking about how two Negroes managed to buy two banks full of white folks' money and loan it to other Negroes.
You should have known you couldn't keep this a secret very long.
FBI, you're under arrest.
A black man tries to bring other brothers up. That's intolerant.
Oh, when you're working on faith. Oh, when you're living on faith. Something's got to give. Something's got to give.
Even a rig gang's fun to play by now.
If this was easy, somebody else would have done it a long time ago.
Something's got to give.
You're a revolutionary.
Yo, be on assuming I'm taking her to the I didn't step in. So Mr. Funk Master, yo, be on assuming you know. There's too many, you know.
So to understand the Asian eyes, you know, which all women have irrespective of their ethnicity, we need to first of all explain what you're looking at when you look at a male over a female to understand why women have Asian eyes. So first of all, the reason why we're using a black man here is because everybody in this world came from a black man, including all women as well. So that's why we're using this picture as a reference. So to start things off, we need to explain what you're looking at when you see the oval eyes in a female and why a man's eye looks the way it is. It first of all starts with the fact that males have more testosterone than women. So I want you guys to understand that fact. Males have more testosterone than women, and testosterone is the one important factor that differentiates the sexes. All right, so because males have more testosterone, that means they have more muscle mass, your bones are far more denser and stronger, and overall it affects a lot of things. Because of the testosterone, the high testosterone that men have, the skulls of men tend to be far bigger, and they also tend to be far more pronounced. So because of testosterone, men develop what they call brow bossing. You probably heard of this before, or a brow edge. So it's like a deep hood over the eyes. So if you take a male skull or skeleton and you look at the eye sockets, you find out that around this eye edges right here, there's a thick protruding bone from the eye sockets. So this causes a man's eye to be deeply set into the skull much more than a woman that you're seeing right here. With women here, with any woman at all, because of the lack of testosterone in the body, which is not equivalent to the high testosterone levels that men have, a woman will not have that thick eye socket area over the eyebrow, as you can see right here that I'm hovering my mouse. So that's the first difference between the female eye socket and the male eye socket. So because of the deep protruding bone structure over the eye socket, because men have more testosterone in their bodies, it causes this to grow. So because of the high testosterone that men have, the eye socket here grows in such a way that it looks like it has a cap over a man's eye. So because of that growth that comes out, the skin that's over a man's eye is not oval in shape. It's going to be squared out. So as you can see right here, this man's eyelid right here is squared out because of the brow ridge, because of the high testosterone level, and because the skin is trying to grow to compensate for that hood over the eye, is going to cause this eyelid here to be far more straight. It's not going to be oval in shape. So since women have a lack of testosterone and is not as high as the male testosterone levels, this eyebrow ridge here does not grow over and form a hood. So a woman's eye comes much more, let's say, forward. It's not deeply set in the skull as a man's eye because of that. So a man has a hood or a ridge over his eyes, so his eyes appear to be like deep slits in his face, while a female own comes out much more further. It's plain. It's not deeply set. Because of the high testosterone that males have, the eye now has to grow, like the eyelid, all right, has to grow to compensate for the hood over the eyes, and this causes this place here, the eye socket, to be much more straight. While that of female, because she doesn't have that testosterone, the skin doesn't have to grow to cover the hood over our eyes. It's more oval in shape, as you can see right here. It's more oval. So because of the high testosterone that males have different kinds of eye slits in their sockets, especially the black males, because black males have the highest testosterone in the whole entire world. So it causes the male eye for males to be of different kinds of slits. All right, because the testosterone causes the brow ridge to grow in such a way that it protrudes. So the eyelid now has to grow to cover up that skin down to the eye. And so males will have different kinds of eye slits. With women, all women will have this kind of eye, Asian eyes, in which the top part of the eye is fully oval. With males, it will never happen this way, as you can see right here. So let's see some other pictures so you can see the differences in black males. So here is another picture right here. As you can see, the hood over the eye, the eyelid grows to accommodate for that, and it's not oval in shape, as you can see right here, all right, because of the skin, because of the high testosterone levels that males have. So let's go to another picture. So with this particular picture, you can see very clearly here that there is a lot of distance between the eye socket and the eyelid. So it causes the male, black males especially, as we have said, they have the highest testosterone levels in the world. It causes the eye sockets to be of different ranging shapes and not oval in shape like a black woman, or females in general all around the world. So let's go take a look now. So regardless of where the woman is from, her ethnicity, you know, wherever she is, whosoever she is, she's always going to have this oval eye shape because of the lack of testosterone in the body, which is not as high as males, which will not cause the woman to have any sort of brow ridge, which causes the eyelid to grow to accommodate that ridge and will give a distortion in the socket, the eye socket of every female. So most women might say, okay, when I look in my mirror, I don't actually see myself having this oval shape eye that women have. There are some factors that can contribute to that. One of the factors that will contribute to you not seeing this oval shape is if you're way too overweight. You have too much fat in your body, because people don't understand that when you get fat, when you accommodate fat into your body, you accommodate fat everywhere. It's not just in your bum or thighs or abdomen or arms. You accommodate fat everywhere in your body when you gain fat. All right? So if you have a lot of weight on you as a woman, it's going to cause the fat in your eyelids to be so accumulated that you're not going to see this oval shape that's known or has been told to you that only Asians do. So let's get to the point of now talking about the fact, why is it that we notice only that Asians seem to have the slant eye that we know Orientals to have them, all right, in both the males and the females? So we want to answer that question now. And we also want to answer the question why it seems that in certain males, they also have a slant eye or Asian look. So let's get into answering that now. To start with, let's take a look at why the Asian look is so, so noticeable. First things first, the reason why the Asian look is very, very noticeable is because of the fact that Asians or Oriental, first of all right, have a lack of testosterone. And that goes for anybody who has straight hair. Anybody that has straight hair or is mixed, as some people might be confused about the fact, thinking that if you're mixed that you're part black and part albinic. There's no such thing. As long as your hair is not woolly hair, if it's mixed hair, you are still suffering from albinism, which is a genetic sickness, a genetic disease, which should be treated as any of the diseases around the world, such as maybe cancer, cancer is fake, should be treated as any of the real diseases around the world, something like, let's say, maybe cold and flu, and what else should I name out there that's a real disease? And stuff like, measles or smallpox, because it's a genetic deficiency. It is a sickness. Albinism, having straight hair. So the first reason why Orientals, all right, have the noticeable Asian look is because of a lack of testosterone, number one. Number two, the second reason why is because their forefathers were inbreeding. So as you've heard before now, the slant eye look was only in the female black population, or generally in female black women, who are the progenitors of everybody that is an albino today. So it was only present in the black female population. But when inbreeding, all right, that means the nuclear family is inbreeding. You have cousins procreating with their cousins. You have siblings procreating with brothers and sisters, as you watch in the show that's called Bates Motel, starring Vera Farmiga. I hope I got the name right. You can look it up, Bates Motel. It's trying to tell you that story of the fact that inbreeding is going on, but a lot of people don't understand what you're watching because you're watching entertainment in how a mother and her son are having fantasies over one another. And the son that was born in that relationship in Bates Motel, as the story would have showed you, was born from a sibling, the brother that was living with her sister. So let's get back to the story now. So the reason why the Asiatic look is present in both the male and female population is because of inbreeding. So if you find any black person who's a male who has this Asiatic look as well, it means that someone in the lineage is a close relative, either a brother or a sister, uncles or aunties, or cousins were procreating, so they are directly related. So if you find a male having that slant Asian look eye, all right, a black male, then you know that's what happened. So inbreeding caused the Asiatic population, which includes Iranians and Oriental people all around the world, to now have a cross of the Asiatic look or the slant eye look, which was only present in the female population, it crossed over into the male population as well. So that's why people of Asian descent, especially Orientals, both the males and the females, have that look. As we've explained, because one, a lack of testosterone, which everybody who has straight hair has, and then also because of inbreeding, that cross the look that females usually have, which is the Asian look, into the male population. So the reason why the Asiatic look is very noticeable is because of one thing and one thing only, and that's what you're looking at the screen. Now, usually with people, this is what your eyelid looks like. So this is what everybody's eye that's regular, especially with black people, who are the ancestors of everybody that's an albino today. Everybody besides the Asians have this fold in their eyelids. So with regular people that are not Asians mostly, this is what your eye is going to look like. And let's go through some pictures again so you can actually see that everybody who's not Asian has a fold in their eyelid, because we want to explain why the Asiatic population, especially those of Oriental descent, have the oval-shaped eyes, which was only present in the female population, now being borne by both males and females in the Oriental population. So let's take a look at regular pictures first, then we come back to this. So these are regular eyes. As you can see right here, there is a fold, there's a crease in the eyelid. Sometimes they call it a double lid, all right? So with regular people, you will always have this double lid or crease or fold, whatever name you want to choose for it, in your eyelid. Now with Asians don't have this kind of fold in their eyes. They have what they call a monolid. That means the crease is not present in the eyelid. Now let's go and look at that first and read some few things on you to understand why it's necessary that we have to show you all this, because this is going to make sense later on in the video. So Asians or Oriental people in general have what we call a monolid or an epicanthic fold. So we want to read that to you so you can understand, then we'll go back to pictures and show you what we're talking about. It says here, epicanthic folds. It says, an epicanthic fold is skin of the upper eyelid that covers the inner corner of the eye. The fold runs from nose to the inner side of the eyebrow. Now, this is from a website that's called Mount Sinai. Mount Sinai, I think, is a medical hospital, or it's a medical organization somewhere in New York. We'll leave a link of this on the screen for you to go read up yourself. So let's continue reading now further downwards. It says, causes. Epicanthic folds, which means to have a monolid. That means you don't have a regular crease in your eyelid, as with all people generally have. But Asians in most cases have what they call a monolid. They don't have a crease in their eyelid. They don't have a fold. All right. So let's continue reading. It says, epicanthic folds may be normal for people of Asiatic descent and some non-Asian infants. Let's keep on reading. Epicanthal folds also may be seen in young children of any race. Race, there's no such thing as race. This is them reading stuff into your mind so you do not understand what they're saying in this particular document that we're reading. There is no such thing as race. What you have are ethnicities. If you're albino, that means you have straight hair. You do not belong to any so-called race. These are all deceptions to hide what's really going on here. So let's keep on reading. It says, epicanthal folds also be seen in young children of any ethnicity. That's the right word to say, before the bridge of the nose begins to rise. However, they may also be due to certain medical conditions. All right? So it's saying that normal people, all right, should have a fold in their eye, in their eyelids. So with Asiatic people or Oriental people who don't have this fold, that it is a medical condition. But we don't want to rush to any conclusions now, because at the end of the video, this is going to be a very long video, you will understand solely what this is all about. But let's keep on reading so you can understand where we're going. It says, however, they may also be due to certain medical conditions, talking about the epicanthal fold, including Down syndrome. I want you to listen now carefully. Down syndrome, fetal alcohol syndrome, Turner syndrome, phenylketonuria, Williams syndrome, Noonan syndrome, Rubin-Tsin-Tebai syndrome, and blepharophimosis syndrome. Now, we're not going to have time to go through all of the syndromes, but in a general sense, what this information is trying to narrate to you is the fact that if you have an epicanthic fold, or you have a monolith which is present in the Oriental population the most, in which something that's prevalent in the Oriental population, that you have a genetic sickness. Now let's get back to what we're going to say and talk some more so you guys can understand where we're heading with all this, because this will make sense by the end of this video, and it's gonna be a very long video, so stick around. So the question now is, so as we explained earlier, the reason for the Asiatic population having the look, because I want you to remember that we're still stuck on the fact that all females have oval eyes because of a lack of testosterone, which doesn't make females to have some sort of protruding eyebrow, or what they call a brow ridge in their skulls, which causes for the eyelid now to grow a little much more longer to cover that protruding eyebrow ridge, and then causes the eyelid in such a way that it doesn't have the oval shape for males. So that's what women have. They don't have any eyebrow ridge. Okay? So the reason for the fact that Asians have a noticeable look in which it looks like they all have slant eyes, which was only present in the female population throughout history, but crossed over into the male Asiatic population, is because of inbreeding. That's number one. Number two is because of a lack of testosterone. Since usually, and it is a fact, all right, that anybody who does not have woolly hair, it means that if you have straight hair, it means that if you're not black with woolly hair, it means that if you are mixed and your hair is not woolly, it means you have a lack of testosterone. The reason for the lack of testosterone is because you are an albino. It's because it means that your forefathers were procreating within their nuclear family and have passed this genetic defect of denatured carbon, which is falsely called melanin and melatonin. And that is what causes you to have a lack of testosterone. So when you lack testosterone, which is prevalent in all albinic population, anybody with straight hair, if the hair is mixed, it means you are an albino. You're not black. You have a lack of testosterone. And that is the reason why people who have a lack of testosterone, which is present in all populations that have straight hair, have problems of so much magnitudes, which we are going to talk about later. So what is woolly hair? How do we explain what woolly hair is? For you to know if you have woolly hair, what you have to do is this. It's a very simple experiment. Put your hair in a cornrow. A cornrow is that type of row, is that type of hairstyle in which a lot of black people use. And let's show you an example of what a cornrow is. So here is an example of a cornrow. It's a type of weave in which black women and black males put their hair in a weave like this that you can see. So it looks like a cornrow. The name is gotten from the fact that if you plant corn on a farm, you put it in a cornrow. So that's what they call a cornrow. So if you want to know if you're black or not, so put your hair in a cornrow like this. I'm not talking about the upper part here that's a ponytail. I'm talking about this part here that is a row. Put it in a weave like that. Now, if the hair does not come off. Now, one of the things that you have to do before you put your hair in a cornrow is this. You have to make sure that your hair is free of all texturizers and relaxers, and that it is your own natural hair. That means you've added no ironing to it, hot iron or flat ironing. You've added no texturizers to it. You've added no relaxers to it at all. Just put that hair in a cornrow naturally. If the hair does not come out of that cornrow until you pull it out yourself, it means you're black. If after you have put the hair in a cornrow like this, right, or like that, okay, and it comes out after a certain period of time, it means you are suffering from albinism and you are not black. Do not deceive yourself. So that's how you know if you're black or you're not. Put your hair in a cornrow, your natural hair. If it does not come out with black people, when they put their hair in a cornrow, it does not come out until they pull it out themselves. With anybody else who's not black, after a certain period of time, the hair detangles. Why does it detangle? Because with black people have what they call air pockets in their hair. So the air pocket does not allow for water to get into the hair strands. Now, with people who have straight hair who are albinos, what happens is because the air pockets are no longer in the hair because of albinism, inbreeding that they have gone through, which was started by their forefathers who were black and passed on to them. So with anybody who's not black, they don't have these air pockets in their hair. So water and moisture get into the hair strands, and that is what causes albinic people to have long hair. It seems that they do have longer hair more than black people, but that's not the case. It's because of the structure of the hair. So with black people have air pockets in their hair. So water and moisture don't get into the hair at all. So if a black person wants his or her hair to grow, they have to constantly moisturize the hair to make sure that water and oil get into the hair strands every 2 to 3 days. And then the hair will grow naturally long, longer than any albinic person in the whole entire world. You can go on your search engines and look for the person who has the longest hair in the world. It's going to come out to be a black person. So with albinic people, they don't have any air pockets on the hair strands. So water and moisture from the air around them gets into the hair naturally. And since because the number of hair per square inch has been reduced in albinic people, the water gets into the hair strands because it doesn't have any hair pockets or hair follicles to protect that. So because of that, the hair stays lubricated and moisturized constantly and is able to grow to a certain limit because all albinic people have limits on how long their hair grows, because it, the hair, first of all, is very, very weak in the roots, number one, and also because the strands per square inch has been reduced, so the hair does not have any strength to grow very long. So what do we mean by strands per square inch? So, for example, let's say in black people, they have maybe a million strands of hair per square inch on their head. With people who are albinic, whether they call themselves mixed, as long as the hair is not woolly, because we've just shown you the test to understand if your hair is woolly or not, they will have about 200,000 strands of hair per square inch compared to black people who have a million strands per square inch. So that's what causes the albinic hair to be very, very loose. If you tug at it a little bit too much, it just pulls all the way up. But with black people, it doesn't happen that way. So that is the test for you to know if you're black or not. So go do the test. If you find out that when you put your hair in a cornrow and the hair comes out after a certain period of time, it means that you are not black. With black people, when their hair is in their cornrow, it never comes out until they pull it out themselves. So let's continue on with what we're trying to say before on what happened with the Asiatic look. To the story right here is the fact that the reason why Asians have the noticeable look of the oval eyes, which is only present, all right, in the female population, crossed over into the male oriental males, people who come from Japan, China, Korea, and all the Asia islands or so-called Asians. They are the ones who have this so-called very pronounced oval look, which is only present in the female population, that the males also have because of what they have, what they call a monolith and also an epicanthic fold. So that's the reason why. So, and the reason is because of inbreeding. Because everybody who's an albino, that means you have straight hair, all right? The reason for you being an albino, having this genetic sickness or disease of albinism, is because your great forefathers, all right, were inbreeding within the nuclear family, which is something that is still very, very much prevalent in Asia. You hear of cousin marriages. When you watch, example, a Chinese action movie or an Indian movie, you see how the family pays very, very close attention, more affection than is necessary for their siblings. Why is that? Because it's an Asian culture and practice to procreate with members of the nuclear family. That means parents are sleeping or procreating with their sons and daughters, with their aunties and uncles, with their cousins. And after a certain period of time, when that goes on, the children come out to have pale skin, right? And they have straight hair and no longer woolly hair. This is what the great forefathers of the Asians practiced, who were black with woolly hair. But when that particular practice was promoted to bring about the ethnicities today that they are called the white man, all right? That is what transpired. And because of racism or the caste system that existed in Asia that was promoted around 400 years ago, it now brought about the fact that black people were now meant to be at the bottom of the totem pole. And for them to survive, they had to breed with people who were albinos so their children could have some sort of social status in society away from the suffering that they had. This is what is going on today in the world with racism. Racism makes black people want to be albinos so that they can be a thriving albinic population. Because why? Albinism cannot survive without black people. Why is that the case? Because black people provide what they call melanin and melatonin, which are false words for carbon. Because we are all carbon-based organisms. The more carbon you have, the better chances of you being able to survive. And we'll get into that later. So the reason now we're trying to talk about all this is the fact that for the Asians, the reason why they have this crossover of a female trait into the male population is because of inbreeding. And anybody who's albinic today, because all Asians are albinos, that means they are suffering from the genetic disease or sickness of albinism. Everybody who has straight hair is an albino, and your origins are in Asia. So if you have straight hair anywhere in the world, and you're believing that you're an American, or that you're a Native American, because there's such a term, a Native American, or you believe that you're Native Indian, or you believe that you're Mexican, or you believe that you're South American, or you believe that you're from Australia, or you're from South Africa, or you're from North Africa, or you're European, you are none of those things. Your origins, your lineages are in Asia, in the places of Iraq and Iran, which are people from India, So Iranians and people who are from Iraq are from India. So the origins of everybody who has straight hair today in the world, regardless of where you are, is in Asia. So that is the reason why you have that name for albinic people or white people, where they say Caucasians, because they are from Asia. You're not American. You are not Mexican. You're not South American. You're not Caribbean. You're not European. You're not from Northern Africa. You're not from Saudi Arabia. You're not from Australia. You are Asians, and you're either from India, Iran, or Iraq, which was occupied by Indians, or you're Oriental from any of the Asia states in Japan, China, Korea, and the rest. That's where you're from. So do not bother yourself to go check in for a DNA test. And the DNA test says, oh, you were American, you're 50% European. It's all nonsense. You are Asian. They are only deceiving you to make money off of you. So do not be dumb anymore. So let's continue now. So the reason we are showing you all this is because, as you read earlier in the fact, if you have a monolith, it's a genetic defect, and you're going to find out sooner or later. So let's continue on. Welcome to Tricks of the Estrade channel. Today is the 22nd of November 2019, and this video is called Roll Call. So it's going to be broken into a series of parts. So the one you're watching right now would probably be the part one, just depending on how long. We don't know how long it's going to take, and we're going to be doing something very special on today's video. So today, we're going to be taking a look at United States presidents and those running in power. We're going to do a gender check, starting with any of the presidents that we can possibly find. We're going to go as far back as in history as we can to pick up United States presidents and do a gender check to see if they're really the gender they claim. And we're going to start as far back in history as we can, and we're going to come all the way up to Donald Trump to see if all the United States presidents stand up to a rigorous gender check to find out if they are the gender they claim. So also, this is going to be a final transgender video for a very long time. The reason being, there is no need for us to keep on doing transgender videos if it's not helping anybody, if people are not trying to understand their reality. Because you need to understand the reason why we started making transgender videos in the first place, because a lot of people come to the channel and don't understand what you're watching or the reason why we started producing transgender videos. Now, here is the reason why. The reason why for our transgender videos is to make you to be able to identify who is a liar, who is lying to you right in front of your face. So what does this mean? So let's take, for example, right, that Jay-Z, who's a man, right, is actually dating another man in Beyonce. And Beyonce is a man. So automatically, that shows you that anything that Jay-Z says is a lie. And anybody who associates with Jay-Z is deliberately lying to you, because none of them have ever whispered to the fact that Jay-Z is hanging out with another man in Beyonce. Because when you're up close with a transgender, you're going to know that this is definitely a transgender, except you are not looking at what you're seeing, and you refuse to see, to recognize that there is a transgender right in front of you. Because once you're with a transgender, you're automatically gonna know something is off. You may not know exactly what's off, but you're gonna know that something is wrong here. This person looks like a female, but the vibe that you're getting and what you're actually seeing makes him to be a strange looking female. So that means it must be a man. So the reason for the transgender videos was to make you to look and to understand that there is an organized system of lies in place. If people, your government, the so-called people that you look up to in society, can be parleying around with transgenders, and none of them mention the fact that the person that they are parleying around is a transgender, they don't even mention it in the joke. So because it's very, very weird, all right, that you hear of the so many cat fights and, you know, fighting between hip hop artists, you know, you hear on the radio, on the TV, you hear sometimes Jay-Z has a problem. Sometimes you hear Jay-Z has a problem with 50 Cent, and 50 Cent goes on the air and starts barraging Jay-Z's countenance. But 50 Cent doesn't even remotely mention the fact that Jay-Z's so-called wife is a man. The same thing goes on with Nas. Nas has some trouble with Jay-Z, you hear on the radio, here, so forth and so on. And Nas doesn't even mention the fact that Jay-Z has a wife who's a man in Beyonce. So that's how you know it's an organized system of lies. And there's so many more that you're going to find out. Example with Kanye West today. Kanye West says that he's all for God, he's all for Jesus. He has problems with Jay-Z, but he doesn't mention the fact that Beyonce is a man. So I hope you guys understand that now, so that you can see and know for certain that there is an organized system that's lying to you. If the people that you trust can be parleying around with transgenders and none of them say anything, as in the case with Barack Obama and Michelle Obama. Michelle Obama, a United States president, first lady, was a man, and the whole wide world, none of them said anything to that fact. You didn't hear it on the radio, you didn't hear it on the TV, none. Another example in President Trump's sons. Both of them that we featured on our channel are actually transgender females. And the White House, the so-called senators, and people who create all this debacle of ruling the United States haven't mentioned that fact that the United States president in Donald Trump has sons that are actually transgendered. Or for example, in Jared Kushner, who's married to Donald Trump's daughter. Nobody has mentioned that fact, but they have trouble with either your so-called social security. They say you're running out of social security right now, and that is a major problem. And they're talking about right now in the news that they're trying to impeach Donald Trump, and that Donald Trump is this bad president, but none of them remotely mentions the fact that Donald Trump's son and Donald Trump's son-in-law are all transgendered, because they were born females and they have been transgendered to males. So this is the reason for all the transgender videos that we make. But people fail to realize that. because people do not know how to think. They have been bewitched by the system, which is controlled by Satan. Because at the end of the day, we want you to see how Satanism works so that you wake up to reality. And you don't wake up to the false reality which the government has planned for you by making you to wake up into another deception. That is the reason for our transgender videos. And like we said, this is going to be the final video for a very long time. It's going to be a long video as well because there are so many things that we're going to talk about. And we're going to go through a whole list of transgenders that we haven't featured in a long time. People we have had backlogged up. We couldn't have the time to take a look at them. And it's going to be a rapid fire of names because there's a whole lot that we have to cover. And so we have to go through this with speed. So in the future, since we're not going to be making any transgender videos, if you ever come to the channel and the channel is still around, we'll just be giving you ads of what we're up to. Because like we said, this is going to be the final transgender video for some time. We don't know how long, except something comes up that we need to inform you people. But regardless of that, we'll always have our contact on the screen and you can always contact us. And we'll also have ads later on in the future displaying what we're doing. So with that, welcome. Let's get into this. So for first-time subscribers, watching this particular video is not going to make a lot of sense to you. You're going to have so many unanswered questions. So if you want to catch up to speed on watching the videos and understanding what our channel is all about, for as long as this channel remains, we advise you that you go to the channel and look for the video that's called Primer. There is a playlist for it. I'm hovering my mouse right over it right here. It's called Primer. So you should click on that playlist, and there's about 4 videos that will do you a world of good for you to start watching those videos first. It's called Primer. You have A Theory of Surrogates, A Theory of Surrogates 2, and Primer 2. After you're done watching that video, there is a link in the description section of every video that we have that we do any transvestigations. So what you have to do is get on that link after you finish watching the Primer videos. Get on the link, click on the link, it's going to take you to a document. The document is going to be called Male versus Female Visual Differences. This document lists the visual differences that's used to identify a female over a male. And the one thing that we always say with all identifications of females and males is that it's based on the skeletal structure. Gender is not determined by genitalia. So a man having some sort of penile genitalia or a woman having some sort of vaginal looking genitalia or breast does not make her female. And neither does a man having any sort of penile genitalia make him to be male. All right, so I want you to remember that sex is determined by the skeleton, the skeletal structure. If you don't have the skeleton to be male, you cannot be male. If you don't have the skeleton to be female, you cannot be female. No matter what you do in taking drugs to change your hormone levels such that maybe a man grows breast, or female taking high levels of testosterone that changes her voice and causes her to grow facial hair, she is not a man because nothing can change the skeletal structure. This is what the wicked medical system of this world run by Satan, run by certain families, don't teach you in all your schools. because you have to understand that the reason for the educational system and the medical system, which kills more people than it saves, is to brainwash you into believing a false reality. You have to understand that way back in history, people were not allowed to read and write. It was a taboo to read and write about 700 years ago or thereabout at that point in time. But later on, that law was changed. Why was it changed? Because when there was a law in place that people should not read and write, people knew the truth, right? And whatever they said and whatever they passed around as information was the truth, because they were not susceptible to the lies that was being propagated during the Renaissance period. So when the same people who are running the world today found out that making it a taboo, right, for people not to read and write is at their own detriment, because if people cannot read and write, they cannot read and write the bullshit that you feed them and pass it on to their own generation such that it becomes the truth, even though it's a lie. So without people not being able to read and write way back in time, it was better for them to believe what they wanted to believe, because they couldn't just go read anything that the so-called government that was running the world and is still running the world today through the Vatican could feed to them. So what happened was the Vatican now had to relax the law and tell people that it was no longer a taboo to read and write, because by this time the Vatican had published enough books filled with so much lies to confuse people. Go and take a look at your history. The first schools were churches. And then after that fact, when the Vatican had made sure that they had enough lies to feed the people, so they had to make the law now that people should be able to go to school. And that's how the educational system was put in place, for you to read false books, lies, and history, and pass it on as if it was truth. The law that said people should not read or write was called Liberum Prohibitorum. We'll put it up on the screen so you can get on your search engine so you can find out this particular truth. So what you have to understand today, as at this point, is that the educational system and the medical system has only been set up so that people can read and write the false histories which has been passed on to us through the Vatican, through the families who run the world, so that you can spread this all around as truth and believe these stupendous, stupid lies which the government feeds to you. So you become brainwashed into an animal that can only be controlled by inputs. So whatever inputs the government give to the population, they know the reaction, because they are basing your reaction on the false histories and stories that you're taught in the educational system and in the medical system, as well as the religious system. So you'll never find this particular teaching in any school which tells you that sex is based on the skeleton, that is not based on the genitalia. Why is that the case? Because in the creation of man, when the Creator created man, man as a man has the XY chromosome. A woman came out of a man. So for example, the male genitalia is inverted for the female. So everything in the male is inverted for the female because the woman came out of the man. So when that now happened, the skeleton is inverted also, because the genitalia of the man is inverted for the female. So which means that the male genitalia actually carries a female genitalia as well. A man has breasts. It's inverted for the female. It grows. If a man takes hormones, the breast will grow and look like a female too. So they don't teach you this in schools because they do not want you to know that sex is based on the skeleton, is not based on the genitalia. That's why a female's hips are below her crotch so she can give birth, and a man's hips is above his crotch because he does not have to give birth. It's an inversion. The creator is way too wise. So when you get on this document, after watching the primer video, then a lot of the things that we are saying is going to make sense to you. But first of all, let's dive into this document so we can continue. The first thing we want to show you is that a female always has an arch in her back. The arch is because the pelvis of a female is tilted forward. Why is the pelvis of a female tilted forward? It's tilted forward so a baby can stay in there for the duration of conception. A man's pelvis is straight because a man does not need to give birth. So a woman has an arch in her back because her pelvis is tilted forward. A woman will always have an arch in her back regardless whether she's big, she's tall, she's small, of any ethnicity. It doesn't really matter. A woman always has an arch in her back regardless of what she does. So as you can see right here, here is an albino female, arch in her back. All females have an arch in their backs. So we scroll further down into the document just to show you some more things so you can actually see that a woman always has an arch in her back regardless of her shape, size, height, or anything. Here is a female, arch in her back. Scroll further down in the document just to show you that it doesn't matter if you're working out, there's always going to be an arch in a female's back. As you can see here, here's a female kneeling down and there's an arch in that back. A C-shaped arch in the back for all women. So regardless of their shape, their size, there's always going to be the arch in a female's back. And let's show you some more information right here in this document for you to see that. Here are females who work out. Always arch in her back. So here's a big female to the left of her screen. The pelvis is still tilted forward. There is an arch in that back. And here's the same female again, smaller. Pelvis is tilted forward, arch in her back. It doesn't matter if the woman works out, right? You lift a lot of weights. It doesn't matter if the woman takes so many male hormones. There is always going to be an arch in a woman's back because you can't change the skeletal structure. So you see a lot of people who are wicked to themselves, because one thing I have to say is this. A lot of people think that wickedness means that you have to do something wicked to somebody else. So if you haven't done anything to anybody, you can virtually say, well, I am not a wicked person. I'm just doing me. But the Creator will judge you for being wicked to yourself. Wicked to yourself in going, in doing so many stupid surgeries that you don't need. Butt implant, breast lifts, taking hormones to change your structure, taking hormones to change your female appearance to a male appearance, or taking hormones to change your male appearance to a female appearance. The Creator will judge you for that. You have been wicked to yourself. There'll be no escape for you. Taking her to the fever. I did this again.
ain't happen. So Mr. Funkmaster, yo be long, yes, woman. Taking her to the I happen. So Mr. Funkmaster, yo be long, yes, woman, you know.
Because all the nonsense that people do, all these surgeries, is unnecessary. Because let's ask this simple question. The idea of hospitals is something that just started maybe about 500 years ago. Let's ask this good question. This earth has been around for almost close to 7,000 years as of 2019. Before hospitals were invented 500 years ago or thereabout, I want to ask you this question. How were your great-grandparents surviving? How were they giving birth to children? How were they living longer and stronger than you, who has been dumbfounded, who has been made stupid, that everything that goes on wrong with you, you have to run to the hospital first? How did your great-grandparents survive without a hospital? And they live longer than you, who have all the medical care and medical insurances in the world. Because you dumb people refuse to see that the medical system only makes things worse for you. You go in to solve one problem and you come back with 1,000 complications. And we'll show you more proof later on in the video. So how did your great-grandparents survive without a hospital? It's because the system has brainwashed you to be dependent, not to grow your own food. You have become dependent on the nonsense they feed you, from the water you drink to the food you eat to the animals you eat to the fish you eat and consume. And that makes you sick. Your great-grandparents were not in hospitals because they grew their own food. And they were also very honest and sincere people. Not like there wasn't evil, but most people were still honest and sincere. And this same people who run the world today through the Vatican have been continuously feeding lies into the population until it is what it is today, that you cannot have a headache without thinking about going to the doctor. So whatever the doctor tells you becomes your God. The doctors have become God. There are very few real diseases in the world. A lot of the things that you go to the hospital for are poisons. And here is the truth that you have to know. Every sickness and every disease is a problem of food. You're not eating the right food. Every sickness and disease, whether it be a headache. If you have a headache, there are so many things that constitute to you having a headache. One, you don't have enough rest. Two, you're not sleeping well. Three, you're not eating well. That makes you to have a headache. If you have those three things in place, you'll never have no headache. So that's what constitutes a headache. It's your body telling you that you either lack the nutrients, you don't have enough rest, and you're not sleeping well. That's all what it is. But yet people go to the hospital for a headache. They have become dumb and stupid because they refuse common sense reasoning and logic. The only real diseases in the world is anything that has to do with cold, flu, and certain things like smallpox, measles. They are all forms of leprosy. Cancer is not a disease, is not a sickness. AIDS is not a disease either. To know more of this, you can contact us and get the videos that you need. But we don't have time on this video to get into all that discussion right here, because people refuse to learn the truth. They love their wickedness and their dumb, stupid society and stupid egos instead of learning. They think they know something, but they're headed for a place that they'll never ever imagine did exist, because this system, this government tells you doesn't exist. So getting back to this, we want to make you understand that sex is based on the skeleton. If you don't have the skeletal structure, you are not the sex you claim. So it doesn't matter if a woman takes hormones, works out in the gym, she's always going to have an arch in her back, because that's what she was created for. She was created by the Creator to birth children. That is the duty of all women. Women feel at home being what they were intended to be. Now, society has made us to believe in such a way that we were not born in the right body or right minds. You'll never see your dog say that it was meant to be a cat. You'll never see a dog try to meow. You'll never see an elephant try to be a lion. You'll never see a plant tree, like let's say any plant tree in the world, trying to say, I am not supposed to be this plant tree. But this wicked satanic government has preached through the educational system to you that you can change your body, because you are saying that the way you find yourself is not the way the Creator intended for you to be. The reason why we are all sick, sick mentally, sick in our bodies, sick physically, sick in our minds, is because of all the garbage that the government feeds you. Not just the food, but the educational system, the thoughts that it passes down to you and hides behind, pretending that it's not the one doing all this. Through the media system, through the books that you read, through the TV movies that you watch, through the songs that you listen to, the human mind has been conditioned to be full of filth, such that a man can say that he was not supposed to be a man, that he is supposed to be a woman. All this is coming from the government, because what the government passes to you and feeds to you every day, it does so through demons. Everything that you hear, see, or touch is run by demons. The government propagates demons into society, and this infiltrates the minds of men and turns them to be children of Satan. Because genetically now they're thinking like the devil, like Satan himself. A lot of people might say, this is not real, this is not true, but you can see the effects every day. A man wakes up and says he's no longer supposed to be a man, that he's supposed to be a woman. A man wakes up and instead of being attracted to beautiful women, he says he's now attracted to males. And same goes vice versa with females. What do you think is causing all that? So here we are in a state because of all the nonsense that's being fed to us day and night. People have a mentality now that is sickening and wicked. Why? For the government to succeed in what it's doing to the population, they have to make you all immoral, wicked, devoid of good thoughts, so that they can continue being the rulers of society. So that when they are wicked, you cannot catch them, you cannot call them to order for being wicked, because you are wicked and despicable as they are. That's what's going on. So, learn the truth. Get on the primer videos and understand what we're all about. Get this document and study it for yourself. And know for a fact that nothing can change the skeletal structure of a man into a woman or a woman into a man, and therefore you cannot change your sex. If you were born a man, it was deemed necessary for you that you were to be a man. If you were born a woman, it was deemed necessary for you to be a woman. If you find yourself being sick in your body and having some sort of ailment, you should know that this was caused by someone. It's caused by the food that you eat, and all the foods that we eat are controlled by the government because they are not allowing you to grow your own crops and raise your own animals for food. So a child gets born and is deformed because of the food, because of the wicked medical system, which we're all going to get into by the end of this video, so you guys can clearly understand what's going on. For now, I want you to know that sex is determined by your skeletal structure. That no matter who you are, you can't change your sex because you can't change the skeleton. So a female who's taking a lot of hormones to change her physique and have muscle mass like this woman that you're seeing right here, she still will have an arch in her back because she was designed to have babies. And same goes with another female right here. As you can see, there's still an arch in the back because the pelvis is tilted forward and nothing can change the skeletal structure. So moving on, let's show you one more thing about the skeletal structure of a female that differentiates a woman from a man. So the primary difference, the single most pertinent difference when you're doing a gender check of anybody is that you have to understand that a woman's hips, because she has childbearing hips, is below the crotch. So with all females, from underneath their elbows, they begin spreading and getting wider. And at the widest point, the hips are going to be below the crotch. Now, over here is a man right here. With a man's hip, because a man does not give birth, his hips is above his crotch, as you can see here. This is the measurement of where the male hip and where the female hips are at. And as you can see right here in this picture over here, the measurement is above the crotch because that's where a man's hips are. So let's play a video over here for you to see this measurement to understand that this is a female hip. So as you can see right there, the tape goes round, and I'm going to pause it right at that moment so you can actually see where it's at. As you can see, the tape goes round and it's below the crotch of a female. For the male over here, it's above his crotch because the man's hip is above his crotch because his genitalia needs to be outside the body for optimal performance. So he doesn't give birth, his hips are above his crotch. For a woman, the hips are below the crotch because the hips need to be wide enough to carry children and for children to come out of the birth canal. So this is the primary difference that you have to understand when you're doing your gender check, because in the world we live today, people can do surgeries, and they have believed, since the system has preached to them, that you are only the gender you are in your mind. I mean, this is ridiculous. It's one of the most ridiculous things that anybody could ever imagine, because you'll never see a dog try to be a cat and say, I was born in the wrong body, so now I have to try to meow like a cat. But human beings have been taught this by Satan. Why? Why have human beings accepted this fact that they are saying that they were not created in the right body by the Creator who created the dogs, the cats, the trees, and all the animals, and all those animals never have ever said, I am in the wrong body, I ought to be something else. But these human beings have imbibed. Why? Because they are wicked, they are children of Satan, and they have forsaken their Creator by listening to somebody else. So that's what's going on. So let's make this video a little bit larger, because there's certain defining features that you need to understand when you're looking at a woman, so that you'll never be deceived by all the fake stories that's being told to you that a man can change to a woman or a woman can change to a man. Because as we've told you, sex is determined by the skeletal structure. So let me move this clip a little bit further so you see what's going to happen here as this woman is going to turn around about the one defining feature. So I always tell this to people. If you're trying to identify someone's gender and you have difficulty seeing where the hip location is at the front, try to see if you can find a picture of the person from the back. Because once you see a woman from the back, there is no mistaking the fact that she is a woman. Why? Because it's going to show very much from the back, when the way she walks, that the hips are below the crotch. Now, here's one trait which a lot of people don't know. From the back of a female, the hips are slightly above the bum line. They are very, very close to a woman's bum line. Now, this goes for every woman in the world. It doesn't matter what ethnicity you claim, what's the color of your hair, what's the texture of your hair, and what you look like. A woman's hips are always going to be below the crotch. From the back, when you look at a female, you're going to know that's definitely a woman. Okay? So, with females, the hips from the back is slightly above the bum line. Very close to the bum line. If this was a man, this bum line, this hip location would be farther up and the bum line would be farther down. And we're going to show you an example right away. So let's get into that. So we want to show you an example of what a man looks like from the back, because the wicked medical system of the world, controlled by Satan through families, has made doctors to be established in making men try to look like women, with them forgetting the fact that skeleton determines the sex. This particular video that we want to play is from a transgender contest in Mexico. And we're going to show you all the details about that particular contest in a minute or so. But what we want to show you is the fact here that no matter what a man does in trying to look like a woman, the hips of that man will always be above his crotch. It will never change. The same goes for a female. If a female tries to look like a man, no matter what she does, her hips are always going to be below her crotch, as you're seeing right here. So we want to show you this video of this man walking from the back so you can see the difference, because as we explained in the females, the hips are just slightly above the bum line from the back. But if this were a man, this hip would be farther up away from the bum line. So that's what we want to show you with this particular man on the left in this transgender contest in Mexico. The premise for this transgender contest being so popular around the world is that the government establishes this transgender contest in the hopes of trying to make people to accept what is not normal. It's not normal for men to act like women. It's not normal for women to act like men. But this is what is promoted through the system so that the whole entire world will be soaked up in confusion, so you can't see the people who are pulling the strings. This is what it's all about. Because as long as everybody's knowing bullshit, you can't have enough knowledge to figure out what's going on and why we are the way we are and what's really going on in the world. Because there's a reason for all this. And the price and the cost is your soul. So let's play this clip now for you to see what we're talking about, in that this particular man right here is going to try to act like he's a woman, but he's not. First of all, you can see right here that the hips are above the crotch. That's the crotch right there. And the widest point on that hip is above the crotch. If this was female, the hips would be below it, not above, as this man is doing. And we're going to show you certain other things. Like we said, you're watching advanced techniques right now of how to identify the gender. But the only thing that you need to know is that a man's hip is always going to be above his crotch, and the female hip is below the crotch. You don't need to know anything else besides that when you're trying to identify the gender of someone. Every other thing that we're going to show you later on, because it's necessary for this video, is advanced. It's advanced in the sense that you have to be able to pay attention to all the necessary details before you can use it. But the one thing that will never ever fail in a gender check are the hips. A man's hips will always be above his crotch. There is nothing that can change that. There is no drug, no surgery that can change that. Everything else the man does in trying to look like a woman is an illusion. It's because you do not know that sex is determined by the skeleton, so you can fall for it and say genitalia makes one a man or a woman, which is not the case. So let's play this clip now and move it a little forward, because we want you to see what's behind. So you can see that the way this man here is walking, he's swinging himself from left to right, right and back and forth, trying to mimic how a woman walks. Now, the reason why a woman walks that way is because her hips are below the crotch. A man's hips are hooked right up to his legs, so he just needs to walk when he's walking. He just needs to move forward. All he needs to do is just take out one step and he's forward. With a woman, the legs are inside the center gravity of the body. The hips are wide. They are outside. Okay? They are outside the body. So if you look at a female, the widest point in her body is going to be her hips. It's going to be outside the torso of her body. When a woman needs to walk, because her center of gravity is outside, right? So she needs to balance how the way she walks. So her legs need to do two things. The legs need to come inside and forward at the same time, which is causing the woman to swing from side to side, because it's trying to manage or maneuver the center of gravity so she can walk. This is what women do unconsciously without knowing, because that's how their brains are wired to do it. So a woman's legs are doing two things. It's coming inside to the center of gravity of the body because it's hooked right here, all right? So it needs to come inside and forward at the same time. And that's what's causing the female gait. So it looks like she's catwalking. With men, men don't catwalk because the legs are lined right at where the hips are. So it just goes forward. So when a man walks, he leans his weight to the foot that's behind him. When a woman walks, she's leaning all her weight to the foot that is in front of her. I hope that makes sense. So this man here in this particular video is trying to deceive you that he's a female, right? Walking from side to side in a catwalk manner. So that's why all the swinging is, because they are trying to copy the female gait. So let's see what's going on now. So as you can see, from the back now, this man turns around, and I want you to stop right there and see what I wanted to show you. This is the bum line for this man. As you can see, the hip location is so far away that it's so obvious. I hope you guys see that. We're going to run this back a little bit and play it again so you can see that, okay? Right there, you can see this is the bum line, right? And the hip location is so far away, up away from the bum line. Why is that the case? Because this is a man. The illusion that they have tried to make you believe that this is female is that this man has butt implants. So because of the butt implants, it looks like you're looking at the butt, because naturally, men are designed to look at a female's behind. It's a natural occurrence. It's the way men are biologically designed. They're designed to look at the female behind and the female midsection. So once a man sees that cue, he's going to say, oh, that's a woman. So because of that, since the wicked medical system who run the world know that that's the cue that men take, they put a bum or butt implant on this particular man and make you try to believe that this is a woman when it's not. In any way, shape, or form, as you can see right here. So as you can see right here, the man's bum line, all right, is so far away from the hip. That's why it looks this way. And let's run this back one more time before we continue so you can see that slowly. See that? The bum line is right here. And the widest point of the hip is so far up here. And because of the bum implant that this man has, you can be deceived into thinking that you're looking at a woman, but it's not, all right? Because right here, it shows that the bum line is so far up away from the crutch. So the one thing you can never get wrong when you're trying to do a gender check is the hips. A female's hips are below the crutch. From behind, it's slightly above the bum line. And if this was male, the hips would be so far away from the bum line that you would notice that difference. So that is one thing I want you to remember. Let's move on and show you some other things, because the particular video we showed you was taken from a website on a Mexico transgender contest. And let's show you that website before we continue. So this is the website in question that we're talking about. It says here, Mexico crowns transgender beauty queen in bid for acceptance. We'll leave a link for you in the video so you can go look at it if you want to. One thing we wanted to say about this particular deception that's going on in our world is that they tell you right here that this is a transgender contest, right? So normally when you hear that, if you ever went to the show, which I wouldn't want anybody to go, because I don't know why anybody would be enamored by men looking like women when you have real women that you can look at, right? You would expect that when you go to this contest that what you have on display are men, all right, trying to look like women. But since Satan is wicked and the people who run this world as wicked as he is, in order to sell you even more confusion, they allow real women to also get on the contest. Why do they allow real women to get on the contest? Because they want to confuse you, to make sure that it's cemented in your mentality that you can distinguish who is who, because you're looking at the genitalia. You're looking at all the things that are going on outside without looking at what matters the most, the skeleton. So even in this contest, you have a woman also present in it to confuse you. And we want to pull up this picture so you can see it in a much larger frame. So here is the picture in a much larger frame for you to see the deception that's going on, because the government is so sneaky because they are run by Satanists. They are the ones doing everything, but they hide behind the fact and make you believe that they are not. They are the ones influencing every thought. They are the ones who have created everything that you use through the knowledge of Africans. From the phones, the iPhones that you use, to the underwear you wear, the government is all responsible for it. using the knowledge of Africans to do so. Now, let's get into this now. So, this is the transgender contest that we talked about, in which someone was crowned. And you would expect that this should be all men, but they throw in one female. And what we want to make you pay close attention to, as usual, are the hips, for you to see the differences in both. So, this is a man, and this is a woman right here. So, we go further down in the picture for you to see the difference in the hips. This is a man, the hips are above the crotch. This is a female, hips below the crotch. Can you see that? The Q angle, the angle between the hip and the knee, is starting below the crotch. That's the woman's crotch. This is her hip, below it. With this man, it's above here, the widest point. You can see the way that both individuals are placing their hands on their hips. For the man, he's placing his hands on his hips, which is naturally going to be below his navel. With the woman, the way she's placing her hands on her hips is naturally going to be above her navel, because the female navel will be right here, this woman's navel. So the government is full of deception, lying to you. Now, let's move over now and show you some more advanced gender check techniques. So we're on advanced techniques of trying to identify gender. And as we've said, you don't need to know these techniques. The only thing you need to understand is that the female hip is below her crotch and a man's hip is above his crotch. And when you look at a woman from the back, that the widest point in her body is her hips, and it's going to be slightly above her bum line. And for males, it's going to be so far away from the bum line, okay, in the body. So the picture that you're looking at is a picture of a woman. We want you to understand what the female figure looks like. Now, this particular figure is based on the fact that a woman is not overweight. That means she has a considerable amount of fat, which is permissible for her to have to be healthy, okay? Fat is not wrong. It depends on how you're gathering the fat and where it's at, and where it's at. That's the problem. So with this female right here, with every woman around the world, with every single female, the arms of a woman are never straight. They follow the contours of her body. So you can see that this woman is shaped like an hourglass. And because of that, her arms also follow what that hourglass figure looks like. So the arms of a woman will never ever be straight from the elbows. It's always going to follow her figure in an hourglass manner. So a man's arms will always be straight. It's not going to be angled like this, like in an hourglass with a female. So this is one defining technique of identifying the gender. Because when you get to the advanced level of gender check, you can tell from the eyes, you can tell from the navel position, you can tell from the female form, like the arms, but the arms here can be subjective, because what male transgenders do is that they rip out some of their ribs. So when they rip out some of their ribs, the arms of that man will naturally fall to the side. But there is a figure that is supposed to look like when you look at the space between the elbows. So it's naturally going to still follow this shape. But if a man takes out his ribs, the arms will fall to the side. And then since they are taught to be deceptive, a man can walk in such a way to deceive you that he's a woman when he's not. So what they would naturally do is this. They would push the elbows back and push out their chests and let their arms fall to the side and make you feel like it's a woman when it's not. And we'll show you that deception in a minute. But for now, we want you to understand that a woman's arms are never straight. If you tell a woman, pick up your arm and make your palms face your face forward, just pick up your arms naturally and let your arms be at shoulder level with your palms facing up, you will notice that from the elbows of a female, all right, that arm will never be straight. It's always going to angle up. But with males, the arms is going to be straight. It's not going to angle in any way, shape, or form. Except the man is a transgender, has removed his ribs. He's trying to deceive you that he's a woman. He's going to push out his chest. Then he's going to make his shoulders fall behind. So he looks like a woman, trying to deceive you into that hourglass shape in which the female arm is supposed to follow. So as you can see right here, here is a woman. The arms follow the contours of the body, one. And the hip, the widest point at the hip, it's slightly just above the bum line, as you can see right here, because this is 100% female, and her Q angle starts to fall from there. The Q angle is the angle between the hip and the knee. So let's show you another female from the front so you see what we're saying. So here's a woman from the front. As you can see, the arms still follow the contours of the body. They are not straight. They always angle up, trying to follow the hourglass that she has. And the widest point of this female hip is going to be below her crotch, as you can see right here. That's where her Q angle starts, because she's 100% female. With males, if they're trying to look like a woman, what they'll do is they'll push their chest forward, make the arms to drop behind, trying to deceive you. And let's show you that with a video that we just played earlier. So here's a video of that Mexico transgender contest that we tried to show you earlier. And we want to move this frame by frame so you see what we're talking about. So here is the man walking, pretending to be a female. So what you will notice is that he's swinging his arms behind. Women don't swing their arms behind. It's side to side. It's still going to be by the side tucked, but it's not going to go behind like this man is trying to deceive you, because he's trying to give you the female form. So that's why he's pushing his chest out here. As you can see, the arms are now behind, trying to give you the illusion that it is a woman walking when it's not. So you can see that right there, right? See that? See that motion right there? So he's see right here, okay? He's trying to tuck the hand. So what this man has done is pushed out his chest, tucked the hands behind, and tried to deceive you with the female form, but the arms are still straight. And we'll show you what a male's arm looks like in a minute. So we just wanted to run this back for you to see. Let's move on. So here is a picture of a female transgender contest or contestant from Spain. We're going to show you the website that this man was taken from. We're still trying to show you how a man can try to deceive you to believe that they are female based on the structure, the skeleton. Because let's ask this question. How did this man right here in a contestant know all the techniques of being a female? The way to walk or the way to act in such a way is because the government is constantly teaching them, raising transgenders just to deceive you at the cost of your soul. So with this man right here, he's trying to make you believe that he's a woman. So what he does is that he turns his arms, because that's what's going to happen. He's going to turn his arms outwards. He's going to try to tuck it in behind, like we showed you in the earlier video. Push his chest forward and try to mimic the female form. Let's show you the website from where this picture is taken from, because we want to show you some other things. So that picture was taken from this webpage. We'll leave a link for you on the screen. It says here, Miss Spain Angela Pons, the first openly transgender contestant in the 66-year history of the Miss Universe pageant. Remember, if you have watched a video in which we call the Remnant Theme, which is on YouTube, we did explain that everything the government does has to be in worship of Satan. Satan is the one known as the Trinity. The satanic names of this particular trinity, in which people call Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, is actually Jupiter, Juno, and Minerva. Originally called Jupiter before the invention of the letter J, Jupiter, Juno, and Minerva. So everything the government does has to be in worship of the Trinity. So that's why they say in this 66-year period, because it's in a worship of the Trinity. It has to be multiples of threes. We did explain that on the Remnant Film. We don't have time to explain it here. You can go on YouTube and look for the Remnant Film and you can watch all that. But we wanted to show you where the website is that we took that picture from, because there's one more picture we want to show you still on this Angela Pons trying to deceive you that he's actually a female, because we are on advanced techniques of identifying a woman or a gender, because we need it on this video, because we are going to do a presidential rundown as far back in history up till Donald Trump to show you what your government has been doing to you. If these people cannot tell you that they are transgender. And you have the whole judiciary system, the whole law enforcement system in this country, not telling you the truth. Then you can imagine what they're doing to you. That means they're protecting wickedness and killing innocent lives every day. Instead of going after these imposters who sit in the White House and make debased laws that put and enslave everybody. Let's continue on. So here is the picture of that man, okay? In Angela Ponce that we tried to show you earlier of how they try to deceive you into trying to walk like a woman by pushing the chest forward and making the arms to go behind the body to fake the female form. But here is one thing that you guys never know. A man's arm, unlike a female, is always going to angle outside. Okay? A woman's arm angles inside. So let's just pull up a picture so you can see the difference of what we're trying to say here. So here is what we want to show you an example so you understand. So with a female, the arm angles inwards like this. All right? With men, the arms angle outwards. So let me pull up a pen and draw it for you so you can actually see, because this is what I'm trying to show you here from this particular little thing that I drew right here on the screen for you guys to see. So let's try to draw a picture of what we're trying to show you here so you can understand. So here is a female to the left of the screen, and here is a man to the right of the screen. We want to show you what their arms look like, okay, in a drawing. So I'm going to try to draw something so you can see right here. All right. So that's the arm of a female. It's going to be angled inside, just like you can see right here. It's going to follow her hourglass figure. Now with males, it's going to be shaped this way. Okay? It's going to be shaped that way. It's going to be angling outside. This one angles inside. So when I say angle inside, you're looking at the inside of the arm. With men, it's going to be angling outside of the arm, right? So with this man right here, the arm is going to be shaped that way. Right here, there's going to be a protrusion because he's going to be trying to be angling out. With female, it's going to be angling inside because he's trying to follow the contours of her body. All right? This is how a man and a woman's arms are shaped. The female's arm is angling inside the body while the man's arm is angling outside. So on a man, you always see this shape right here at the elbows like that. With females, you're going to see it inside like this. Okay? Now, if a man takes out his ribs and tries to look like a female, it will change the shape regardless of how the space between this elbow and the inside of the arm is supposed to look like. So with men, the space inside their elbows is going to have something like this. It's going to look like, what's the shape of that? Is that like, let me get the name of the shape right before I continue on. So the shape of the inside of a man's arm is going to be shaped like a diamond. So that's the name for this particular shape here, diamond shape. With a female arm, it's going to be shaped this way. It's going to be shaped something like this. It's not going to be a diamond. It's going to look like, let's say, a very soft triangle that's turned to the right. So it's facing the highest point of the triangle is facing the inside or right side of the woman's belly. The shape that we were trying to tell you is that a man's arm is going to be shaped like a diamond. The space in between the arm and his abdomen or his torso, all right, is going to be shaped like a diamond. With females, is going to be shaped something like this. Let me draw it out so you guys can see. It's going to be shaped something like this kind of shape, like this, all right? That's how it's going to be shaped. It's going to be shaped that way. It's going to look like I don't know what to call that shape, but that's more like what you would say, maybe an arrow without, an arrow point. So that's the best way to say it. It's going to be shaped like an arrow point, a soft arrow point two arrows like that. The shape is going to look this way, where the man is going to look like a diamond. So if the man takes out his ribs, it's still going to look like a diamond, but it's going to look like a funny kind of diamond, because what's going to happen is that this part of the arm is going to be made in such a way that it's going to look something like this, all right? And this is going to look something like that, all right? So that's what the shape is going to look like if he takes out his ribs. It's always going to be shaped like a diamond. The space in between that arm and the torso with a female is going to be shaped like a soft arrow. These advanced techniques, because you need to pay attention to the finer details to be able to spot this difference. Because sex is determined by the skeleton. So let's go back to the picture of that transgender man who was competing in a Miss Universe contest. So here is that man here once again. So as you can see right here, there is no space in between the torso and the arm that is going to be shaped like a soft arrow. It's still trying to get the shape of a very funny looking diamond. Same with this arm right here. Still, it's trying to like look like a diamond because the arms of a man angle outside. They don't angle inside like a female because this is not a female. So even with him trying to look female in the fact that he's pushing out his chest, all right, and throwing the arms behind, all right, him, and trying to feint the gait of a female walking in a catwalk manner, this is still a man. Because nothing can change the skeletal structure. So with that, let's get into it now. And do a roll call so you guys can understand this story far better.